Hello everybody, how is it going? Welcome back to a new video. We are here today doing reacting to not a Toby Keith song, but to I've been looking through some of my comments recently on the old Toby Keith videos, and I've decided, you know what, I did say I was gonna look react to some of the guy react to some of the songs that you guys were recommending to me in the comments. So I'm having a look at one today. Before I get into that though, I just want to address something real quick. It's not by any of you guys in particular, it's by like one or two, so I'm only going to address them. Or just anyone who doesn't like my content or the way I do things. All I can really say is, fuck way off. Like, I'm not here to fucking go, okay, I'll do this. This is how I do things. Like, literally, if you don't like me stopping in the middle of a video, or stopping in the middle of a song, which is what reaction videos are about, then go watch someone else's reaction. Or if you talk about how I stumbled my way through videos, it's like, right, well then, don't fucking watch my content. Like, I'm not here to be fucking if you want to take the piss out of me, fine. But I don't understand, if you don't like my stuff, or you don't fucking like the way I do things, then kindly fuck off. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not here to fucking baby anyone. Like, if you don't like my shit, don't watch it. Like, I don't know what to say there. Like, fucking, it's by like one or two guys. The rest of you have all been absolute darlings, and you've been leaving me very positive notes and really giving me positive feedback and constructive criticism. But then there's the few I'm referring to. So just to the few I'm referring to. Right, Darla. That's all you get. I'm not wasting my time fucking getting back to you in the comments when you're just gonna be a cunt. And yeah, I said cunt. I said cunt all day. Cunt, 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 cunt. Fuck, you're a cunt. I don't give a fuck. Stop being a dickhead. Like, I'm not here, like, if you want to take the piss out of me, fine, go ahead. Fucking, I have fucking long, shaggy blonde hair. I have a gap between my teeth. Fucking, lad, I'm like that. I can stand to lose a bit of weight. I don't give a fuck. Don't waste my time. Why not go do something productive with your own fucking time? You know what I mean? And yeah, I'm probably gonna lose some subscribers for this, but I don't give a shit. I don't. Like, if I don't want you in my channel if you're not. I want people to come here and enjoy themselves. Like, I want people to come here and enjoy a unique reaction experience and to create a positive community here, create a unique community. If you don't like that, don't let the back door hit you on the way out. Like, go find another reaction channel. I don't give a fuck. I don't. Like, I know, like, I'm fucking yammering on, and people are gonna be like, oh, you clearly do care. No, I don't. I just don't think you should be wasting your fucking time, or my time, or anyone else's time. You know what I mean? Like, why waste your life reacting to someone, you know, or, like, watching a video with someone reacting to something that you don't like? I don't get it. Why? Just go to a different reaction channel, or make your own reaction to the fucking video, and then do it your way. How about that? That's all I've really got to say here, lads and ladies. That's all I've really got to say. Just the odd one or two dickheads that I've just fucking just have nothing better to do with their lives apparently than just give talk shit in the comments. So go fuck yourselves. And for the rest of my lovely audience, thank you so much for all the support. I love you as the bit. I'm sorry I had to start off the video in this kind of negative way, but at the same time, I'm not taking any shit. I don't give a fuck. I'm Irish. We don't. Anyone who knows what Irish are about, we don't take no bollocks. That's really it. So on that. So getting back to the video, let's try and have a good video. Let's try and have a nice little reaction. You know, produce some positivity. You know, we'll move away from this negative shit and we'll try and create some positivity. Anyway, so yes, let's skip on in to the reaction. All right, everybody, we are here, ready to start this music video reaction. We are reacting to Darryl Worley. I'm not exactly sure, but Darryl's Have You Forgotten. Now, from what I know, this song is about 9/11. So, you know, it's gonna be probably a bit emotional. I was told it's very thought-provoking in a comment in one of my Toby Keith videos, so I'm really excited to get reacting to it. Now, I have put on the subtitles here just in case it could be another Toby Keith incident with me, a young Toby Keith incident where me not fully being able to understand exactly what he's saying. And, you know, like, I'm trying to do my best here because I'm trying to slow down the way I speak. So, and I'm trying to I'm trying to pronounce my words a little bit more. I'm trying to, especially the emphasis on the end, so you guys can understand me. So I'm trying my best here to really slow down and really try and say the words, you know, like really pronounce the words out. So forgive me if I just start going full Irish and just start talking 90 and just go, you know, just Irish rambling. So forgive me if I do that. But anyway, enough of this. Let's get reacting to the video. Let's go. Oh shit, is it full volume? There it is.
I hear people say we don't need this war, but I say there's some things worth fighting for. What about our freedom and this piece of ground? We didn't get to keep them by backing down. They say we don't realize the mess we're getting in. Before you start your preaching, let me ask you this, my friend. Have you forgotten how it felt that day? Your homeland under fire and her people blown away. Have you forgotten when those towers fell? We had neighbors still inside going through a living hell. And you say we shouldn't worry about Bin Laden. Have you forgotten?
Oh, shit, bad time to stop. Right, so I'm just going to take this bit by bit, so I'm maybe not as pausing as much. And just because, stop interrupting the song, you know, like, okay, sure. Anyway. So, right, so here, this is actually a good spot. So, we'll start from this line. I hear people saying we don't need this war. Look, first of all, guys, you know me. You know, I love all the American country, you know, lovely little acoustic guitar intros. It was explained to me that, I think I said this in another video, how there's a affiliation with like Scottish and Irish, you know, music there. And maybe that's why I affiliate, why I like it so much, because it gets the Irish blood in me boiling, you know what I mean? Because it's like, oh, okay, because there is a familiarity there, but it was explained to me. So thank you, person, if you are watching this video, thank you for that. Right, so I hear people saying we don't need this war. So, you know, again, I think there was a whole, you know, pacifism has always been, especially in recent times, I think pacifism has really started coming up. I mean, that's probably a bit naive to say pacifism has probably always been there. But, like, I think it was, now correct me wrong, I think it was very, you know, there was a lot of pacifist, you know, I'm blanking on words here, I'm somehow forgetting the English language, protesters, there's a lot of pacifist protesters for this, and I believe Vietnam, is that true? I'm just getting that off of the fact that one Forrest Gump scene. I'm guessing there was, I know I have some Vietnam, relations to Vietnam vets and also some Vietnam vets. So again, I salute you. I salute all you guys. Thank you for your service. Correct me if I'm wrong there. I think I'm pretty sure there was plenty of pacifist protests during the Vietnam thing and then during this, of course. As for the whole idea of pacifism, I personally don't agree with it, because I personally believe, and maybe this is because of how my life's been affected, and probably a lot of people, like, I know there's been a lot of things that put people in situations in life that I think, I'm going to sound a bit harsh here. Again, if you guys know any pacifists or any pacifists watch this video, I'm not trying to slag off your beliefs. I think, you know, it's naive, but it's a nice goal. But I believe it's naive because I believe life just puts you in these situations. I know growing up in the north of Ireland, you know, there's, you know, as nice as it is, you know, there's still hard feelings left over. Like, if we're talking politics, like, because I know this video is very political. If I'm talking about the politics around my area, you know, there's still a lot of hard feelings left over from the Irish Civil War, the Troubles, and, you know, so that still bubbles up on the surface. So, and then just in general, there's arseholes in every country, isn't there? So, you know, some may try to rob you, some may try to fight you for no reason, simply just shoulder bumping you. So I believe, you know, defending your family, defending your country are ideal goals, which is why I don't really believe in pacifism. Again, I just think it's a rather naive ideal. And I think maybe a lot of people might agree with me on that. But again, try not to slag off anyone's beliefs here. I think it's a lovely ideal, and I good on you for trying to stop the whole no violence thing. But again, I just don't like. It's the same thing with world peace. You know what I mean? Like, I know I should get back to the song. I know some of you guys are gonna give off to me, for not focusing on the song. But I'm just trying to make it relatable for me and maybe talk about issues that maybe you guys can also kind of weigh in on. You know, we don't need this war, but then again, if we're talking about the whole world peace thing, like, world peace, ideal goal, will it ever happen? Probably not. Like, there's numerous wars going on right now, Russia and Ukraine in particular. I'm sure a lot of you guys have different opinions on that. You know, and look, there'll always be, and while we're talking about, let's see, if he's talking about, you're forgetting about just forget about Bin Laden. I really don't think people can just forget about Bin Laden, you know what I mean? It's really not that simple, you know what I mean? Like, fucking causing a massive tragedy like that, just to send a message. It's like, you can't really let that shit go. You just can't. I fully agree with what he's saying here, what the start of the song's being about. It's like, if someone did that to Ireland, it's like, or someone tried to do that to Ireland, it's like, fuck no, I'm joining the defense force, I'm joining the military, and I'm gonna be like a good fuck you, you know what I mean? So I fully relate this, I actually agree with this song, I love it. So far I'm loving the song, I'm loving the sound of it, I'm loving his vocals. I'm actually not having a hard time understanding him. He speaks very clearly, and I'm actually understanding every word, but I'm just gonna keep these on nonetheless, just for my benefit. I'm gonna get back to the song now. So just, yeah, let me know what you guys think about the whole world peace thing, because I personally don't think it'll happen. There will always be another Bin Laden, there will always be another Hitler, there will always be some bigger scumbag who just wants more for the sake of wanting more, if you know what I mean. But let me know what you guys think. I'd love to hear you, because I know I have a lot of vets and ex-vets, or that means the same fucking thing. A lot of vets and a lot of people, you know, that kind of way, and a lot of people who are, again, related to vets. Let me know what you guys think. Let me know what your whole idea on the world peace thing. I'd love to hear from you guys, because I really want, as I said at the start, I want to, like, see if I can get to understand my community. I really want to understand you guys, you know, as I said, I want to build a positive community. But anyway, right, I've fucked off in the video, or music video, long enough. Let's see, we'll go from before the chorus here.
Things worth fighting for. What about our freedom and this piece of ground? We didn't get to keep them by backing down. They say we don't realize the mess we're getting in. Before you start your preaching, let me ask you this, my friends. Have you forgotten how it felt that day? Your homeland. people blown away. Have you forgotten when those towers fell? We had neighbors still inside, going through a living hell. And you say we shouldn't worry about Bin Laden. Have you forgotten?
I know I'm a terrible singer, sorry.
He took all the footage off my TV. Said it's too disturbing for you and me. It'll just breed anger. That's what the experts say.
Sorry, did they really do that? I didn't know they did that. I mean, I'm kind of not surprised they did that. But I generally didn't know they did that. And hold on, what experts is he talking about here? What experts decided that? I generally did not know footage just randomly cut off. I did not know that. Oh, fucking hell, right?
For you and me, it'll just breed anger. That's what the experts say. If it was up to me, I'd show it every day. Some say this country's just out looking for a fight. Well, after 9/11, man, I'd have to say that's right. Have you forgotten how it felt that day to see your homeland under fire and her people blown away? Have you forgotten when those towers fell? Had neighbors still inside, going through a living hell. And we vowed to get the ones behind Bin Laden. Have you forgotten? I've been there with the soldiers who've gone away to war. You can bet that they remember just what they're fighting for. Have you forgotten all the people killed? Yes, some went down like heroes in that Pennsylvania field. Have you forgotten?
That's a little... I don't understand that reference. Sorry, I don't... can someone explain to me that one? The Pennsylvania field one? I don't know, maybe I'm misunderstanding. I don't, what's that referring to? Can someone let me know, please?
Heroes, yes, some went down like heroes in that Pennsylvania field. Have you forgotten about our Pentagon? All the loved ones that we lost and those left to carry on. Don't you tell me not to worry about Bin Laden. Have you forgotten? Have you forgotten? Have you forgotten?
And there it is. Oh, and look, here's "Have We Forgotten." He's playing in front of, like, clearly a lot of soldiers here. So that's interesting. I was actually going to ask about that. He said, let's see, where is it? If I can find it. He said, I think it was around here. Here we go. I've been there with the soldiers. Is that true? Did he obviously I don't think he went in the front lines. Or did he go in the front lines? Someone let me know if he ever has a military thing at all. Because I remember when I was talking about Toby Keith, he got the tank certificate thing, which I thought was really cool. Let me know if Darryl here has ever done anything, if he actually went to one of these types of things and seen off the soldiers or anything like that. Someone let me know, please. Let's see, there's also let's see, where there's a really good line there. I think it was after the chorus here.
Who've gone there with us, and you can bet that they remember what they're fighting for. Have you forgotten?
But I'm sorry, I think it's further back here. It's about, like, people are saying you're just, America's just looking for a fight. Well, and he said, well, fucking damn, yeah, the fucking this psychopath fucking created, made two fucking, I don't know why I'm demonstrating the plane thing, that's, I don't know. I'm just passionate about the goddamn song. These songs get me passionate. I'm feeling the patriotism here, you guys. I'm fucking feeling the patriotism. But, like, the psychopath literally fucking ordered two planes to be flown into the fuck two buildings full of people. Of course you're not gonna take that. That's like a fucking... But why would you take that? Why would you take that lion down? Fuck him. You know what I mean? That fucking scumbag. Like, he's fucking... There's times where... There's times to walk away and there's times to just fight back. Like, again, this is the whole... pacifism versus, you know, thing. And again, there's times where you walk away, turn the other cheek, but then there's times when that shit happens, like, alright, fuck you, you're gonna fucking get it now, you know what I mean? There's times where you just need to fucking, you know what I mean, la? And that's exactly what they did in response, and I absolutely agree with that, it was deserved. I absolutely agree with that. I agree with what he's talking about. In the video. I agree. I've loved the entire song. I've understood it all. You guys are probably going to mention that I've probably missed a few lines. But again, forgive me. I also loved... just the constant support. You know, like, just the mural. Not the murals, but the way shrines... to people, and the constant footage of, you know, being like, you know, you know, we'll always be in our hearts, and just, you just love to, I think you just love to see, like, a community bonding. Unfortunately, it often is what tragedy that kind of binds us together, but the same, like, you know, it's rough to say, but, you know, and it's not probably the nicest thing to say, but for some reason, we seem to really, like, only bond when something tragic happens. That's when we all really, like, bond together. If you know what I mean. So again, this is just all my opinion. You guys are full fair to disagree. You know, fucking everyone's entitled to their own thoughts, their own ways. Again, I'm just clarifying that I was not taking the piss out of anyone's trying to take the piss out of anyone's beliefs. I'm gonna drop this man a full on subscription, a full on like. Let's see. Hold on. Let's read a few of these comments. I love reading a few comments. Someone down here was in the Pennsylvania field. It gives me chills. Again, please, someone... I don't know enough about the event. I'm Australian, who's in New York, and I'll never get that day. I'll always be shoulder-to-shoulder with the US forever. There we go. We have an Australian who's there on that day. Fights because he... Oh, hold on. The true soldier fights not because he hates what is in front of him, but because he loves what is behind him. Oh, I like that. I love that, actually. I like that little quote. I'm going to use that. My son remembers this day well. He was 5 in 2001. Today he's a US Navy sailor, proud of him. That's what it, actually, hold on, what am I doing? Okay, boom, can we give away likes in some of these comments? A lot of our veterans served in Iraq and Afghanistan. Song hits start, boom, look at that. You have to give, like, guys, you know, like, you guys can say, fucking say, maybe I don't, maybe I shouldn't be reacting to this, maybe I haven't, yeah, maybe you're maybe right, maybe I have no right reacting to this. My nation went through its own tragedies, but I feel like I have every right to react to these things as anyone else does, and I absolutely agree that this whole thing was a tragedy, and that you guys, I know, I'm just saying you guys, because I know, again, most of my audience seems to be vets, which again, it really is. I'm really passionate about. Thank you all, and I really hope you enjoy this reaction as well. And again, a big salute and thank you for your service. I don't know if I'm doing it right. Do you do it with the right hand, or, you know, well, fuck, I'm doing it. I'll do it with the right hand here as well, just in case. So thank you for your service. If you were there on 9/11, I'm so sorry that you had to be there during that. I can only imagine the fucking shit that was going through people's minds that day. Such a horrible event, and fucking One day, ladies and gentlemen, one day that cunt will get what's coming on. One day. I don't even know, is he dead? I don't even know. I don't keep up to date with these things. I'm so bad with keeping up to date with current events. Is he dead? I hope he's dead. Fuck him. So, again, thank you all for your service. You're all wonderful people. Hope you enjoyed this. Again, one last time, not trying to take the piss out of anyone's beliefs. If you disagree, that's fine. You're completely entitled to. And if you don't like my comment, you're also entitled to. But don't be a dick about it. Alright? You don't need to leave shitty comments. You can if you want to. Don't know why you did. Just go react to someone else's thing. Or do your own reaction. That simple. Anyway, enough of me. You guys have a good night, a good day, a good morning. Go do something productive for yourselves. Go have a good day. And that's going to be me. I just had a blank there for some reason. Anyway, guys, until the next one, slán go fáil.